direi que the heat should drive the reaction to completion. Also drives off more chlorine. I'm hoping the solution will clear up. Add a tiny bit more acid. See, that's my thermometer dissolving. Error. Thermometer on the outside. This is what I should do. A thermometer well. This is rather a slow process, but it might be starting to clear up a bit. Scientist man. This brick is my little ampule station, making ampules. For example, bromine ampule. As you can see, I keep 2 ampules in here. I shall use them soon. Yeah, there's boiling going on. Where are you going? Oh, he's coming this way. Oh no! The solution is boiling now.
Beautiful day.
Acetone has the property in which it dissolves iron much better than it does manganese. Really bricked up in there. But you can see the color pink, and in the acetone should be dissolved iron. Turn this back up to 75. Warm again. Acetone can be recovered later. And it appears to have increased in volume. It's my first time making this. Credit to Viz Labs, where I got the idea for using acetone. Solubility of iron in acetone compared to manganese. Assuming it works the way it did in his video, go check out his channel. Beep. Oh yeah, there we go, look at that. Reminds me of Blackadder sketch. I've made pure green instead of gold because it was green. Pure green. Let's not boil this too much. A good job. There is some iron contamination still. Lovely. Now to filter it. You can see all the green stuff still about on the filter paper, and
so I don't have much acetone left. I might just separate some of these larger chunks, as they will have iron inside.
That's very nice. Not bad, since we started with 15 grams of manganese dioxide. Almost 25 grams. Here is my water distiller, which needs a clean. Nice and clean, filled with water from the tap. That's the fan and the condenser. Switch it on. This will take some time, but that should fill up with distilled water.